talk is by Padma Shri Dr. Shashank Joshi. He doesn't need any introduction. In fact, he was my teacher in many meetings also. Sir is a consultant endocrinologist, Leelavati and Bhatia Hospital, Joshi Clinic. He is the president of Indian Academy of Diabetes, chair of Southeast Asia chapter IDF, past president of Endocrine Society of India. He has got over more than 800 research publications to his credit, and he is emeritus editor of JAPI, and he was ex-editor of IJIM, and he was a past president of AIARO, and he was awarded International Clinician of the Year 2012 by the American College of Endocrinology. Sir is going to give his talk on debate, precision nutrition, are we there yet? Over to you, sir.
Thank you so much, Dr. Paul, for your kind words. I don't deserve them. And Dr. Murthy and my good friend Vijay Chalru from Corona Remedies, I never thought that when they named Corona Remedies Corona, there would be Corona which would disrupt our lives. And we won't meet physically, but we'll have to meet virtually. You see, the topic today, which I am going to discuss, is that there was a debate at the ADA 2021 on precision nutrition between are we ready for prime time and yes and no. And let us look at what they spoke at that. Then what I will do is like look at the readiness of this debate. Are we really there? What is there beyond the debate which occurred at the ADA in the PubMed field? And do we have some other data which is available with us? And is personalized nutrition going to be a part of that? In fact, on this very same topic, from a team in Bangalore called Twin Health, I am one of the co-authors, we also had a paper on precision nutrition as a poster abstract at the very same ADA, which also I will make a passing mention of. So let us look at the core topic. We are what we eat. You know that the food cooked in every household across the world is different. So the debate was precision nutrition, are we ready for prime time? And it was defended by Dr. Paul W. Franks. He is the scientific director of patient care. And he co-chairs the ADA-ESD initiative on precision diabetes initiative. What Dr. Paul Franks emphasized was the investment in precision nutrition research, can they have a translational impact? And that should be the need of the hour. And precision medicine is nothing but tailoring the various approaches so that we can ensure that we can predict glycemic responses. So his first thing was that is it possible to achieve personalized nutrition by predicting glycemic responses? So fundamentally, they presented data of 10-year follow-up of diabetes incidence and weight loss from the diabetes prevention program outcome study. And Dr. Franks very nicely mentioned that the diabetes incidence was delayed by 36 months with lifestyle modification, while with metformin it was only delayed by 12 months. So obviously we need to look at the various biological characteristics, the genomic influences of the response, because you can have responders and these responders can optimize our dietary choices. Now, for example, we have the similar situations in India, and I will discuss my abstract a little later. Dr. Franks discussed a study quoted in the science journal called Cell, where he revealed that it is possible to achieve personalized nutrition by predicting the glycemic responses, by ensuring that we can get inputs from the gut microbiome, from the blood test results, from various questionnaires, from oxology and anthropometry, and now the latest buzzword of estimating the time in range through the continuous glucose monitoring practices. The core of the universe today is the patient, and we have to focus all our goals on patient-centric outcomes, not just biological outcomes. And in a very nice way, Professor Frank highlighted the need for generating good quality evidence in the lifestyle space, the RCT space. And we have seen that. For example, we had the LUCA-HIT trial, we had the DIRECT trial. These are all lifestyle trials and the DPP program, which were funded by NIH, which shows the relevance of nutrition and its impact on glycemic and weight biology. And that's something which we need to recognize. So Dr. Franks very nicely pointed out that it is important to understand the meaning of glucose variability and the concept of patient-centric outcomes. And obviously, it is equally important because at the end of the day, it is the universe is our patient. So it's very, very crucial to know that we need to adapt and recognize. So what is precision nutrition? I will deviate a little bit and talk to us about our RCT, which is ongoing in Bangalore, with Dr. Paresh Samena and many others are doing. It's a multicentric RCT using an artificial intelligence program where we measure in type 2 diabetics who are less than 8 years of age. And in that, what we are doing is one group is having standard care and the other group is having a CGM, is giving a weight scale, is doing ambulatory blood pressure monitoring. They are also measuring the detailed deep dive on what they are eating through a personalized coach. They are looking at a Fitbit to ensure physical activity and the sleep pattern. And they are also connected to their doctor. This is a comprehensive TIN precision treatment program. We presented that as a poster at the ADA. What we did is that we took all the inputs from the labs, from the sensors for blood pressure and glucose both, and predicted glycemic responses. Every day, a coach was connected to the patient to guide them through an app and through telephonic communication, what to do and what not to do. And then the database was confirmed back with the doctor and the doctor was guiding. And we observed that after 6 months, we were able to take off most of the patients off medications with type 2 diabetes of a short duration. See, restricted dieting of direct trial is tough to do. So we were presenting first piece of precision medicine with precision nutrition at ADA, which supported what Dr. Frank said. So it's very, very crucial to recognize and implant that particular point. Now, the debate always will have two sides of a coin. And obviously, we had a very, very elegant scientist in Kevin D. Hall, who is a senior investigator at the National Institutes of Digestive Diseases and Diabetes at the NIH in Bethesda, Maryland. And he told that precision nutrition is not ready for prime time. He enumerated the various assumptions that precision medicine is based on assumption biology. Individuals have a very variable response on the same nutritional interventions. And therefore, some are responders and some are non-responders. For example, if I eat idli dosa, if my friend and our professor Thomas Paul eats idli dosa, Professor Dr. Murthy eats idli dosa, and Vijay Chaldu eats idli dosa, their glycemic response of all the four of us is going to be different. Also remember that responses are reproducible within individuals. But the variable individual responses can be predicted by omics, microbiota, physiology, social, economic, and environmental influences. So remember, for the same meal, there is a variable glucose response from one individual to another individual. That's what Dr. Hall emphasized. So there is some degree of unpredictability. And the meal ranked order glucose excursion from one individual may not rank similarly for another. And therefore, he shared examples of discordant simultaneous glucose excursions, where the same individual with more than two CGMs recorded two different responses for the same meal. So there are a lot of factors which affect the area under the curve. And there is a lot of imprecision even within the gold standard methods of measuring the energy intake, which has a considerable variability on weight outcome. So he explained through mathematical models, Kevin Hall explained, that the weight change, human metabolism, could evaluate physical activity, food intake, baseline demographics, and compute body fat and body weight. And based on all these data points, they are not very reliable. There are a lot of limitations. So conclusion of Professor Hall was that there are some considerations of precision nutrition he wanted to put on table. The first was that there is a substantial imprecision on the gold standard methods of measuring energy equations of the intake of the food, which imparted some variability on outcomes. Second is that how much is the variability biological, which is the signal related, how much is due to the limits of the methodological precision, which is the noise, is not known. And that limits the accuracy of the outcomes. And we need to do controlled feeding trials, but they necessarily may not solve the existing problems. So it is not ready for prime time. If you ask me, in my final comment, we are in a learning curve. You see, we are in lifestyle medicine. Today, in the era of lifestyle medicine, we have tools to measure. But these tools to measure should be efficiently used for a behavioral change. So if you ask me, lifestyle is not just about eating, about physical activity, about sleep, about medications, but also about happiness and positivity. And if you get an integrated index, which we are able to put through an artificial algorithm and use artificial intelligence, use them and handhold it through a coach, a diabetic coach, and then it is supervised by an endocrine expert, then probably precision medicine can be the order of the day. And precision nutrition is the key cog in that. Because as I said, food cooked in every household across the world is different. Their glycemic responses are different. The fat to carb ratio is different. So there is some degree of unpredictability which we can precisely estimate. Once we do a pattern recognition, and that's what that digital twin type of programs do, they pattern recognize. And once we are able to do pattern recognize, they make corrections. And these corrections then will reset the metabolism, and you might even be able to reverse diabetes or reduce the need for medicines. So remember that we are living in an era where we are able to quantify a lot of our things which we could not do in the past. For example, using the modern techniques of artificial intelligence, we can plot area under the curves of glycemic responses. With the easy availability of sensors for glucose, easy availability of tools like blood pressure measurements, the weighing scales, the ketone body monitoring, as well as the sleep activity and Fitbit patterns. So today's modern diabetology and endocrinology has lifestyle measurements as a key components. And when we personalize that, it becomes precision. And in that, probably the main cog will be precision nutrition. I think I will stop here. And when there is a discussion around this topic, I will come back again to discuss. So remember this debate centered around the ethos of precision nutrition, what to eat, when to eat, how to respond, and how to either manage or reverse diabetes. Thank you, Dr. Paul, for the allowing me to speak in this meeting.
Thank you very much, sir. It was